6:54, wake up Kenosha, Wayless MD and Wellness. They're in the Southport Plaza in Kenosha, waylessmd.com. She is the founder, the chief health strategist. She is an RDN, a CD, a CLT. She's Sherry Stoka is what she is. Sherry, good morning. How are you?
I'm doing well. And yourself?
I'm pretty good. Now, we've got questions from the rain barrel here. Mr. Question Man can't wait. He's diving through the window to get to the rain barrel. So let's hit those questions. Mr. Q Man, what do you got here?
This person says, I was talking with a friend who says they are very strict when it comes to feeding their kids sugar to the point of no birthday cake. Is that overdoing it? Do you, Sherry, have a zero sugar policy?
Wow. I think I've heard Dougal.
Yeah, no birthday cake.
Bill's,
come on.
Bill's in pain over there.
Okay, that's a great question. That in my opinion, is probably the absolute worst thing you could do. I mean, 100%. So our job as parents is to create the healthy environment, make sure that we're offering healthy foods. We are, you know, filling our cabinets with healthier alternatives. If we start to restrict, that will backfire on you. Like the research is so significant that shows when you restrict to that degree, it will end up coming back in full force. And again, if you think about it, these kids, they're going to get it somewhere. So now you're creating an environment of lying and cheating and it's not a healthy environment when that happens.
Just a little birthday cake. What's the problem? Come on. If that was the case at my house, I would have taken a bag of C&H and just started drinking it in front of my parents and just lift it up. Let them have a little fun. It's their birthday for crying out.
Oh my gosh. And your birthday too. That's like the ultimate worst to take that away on that day.
That's a lot of therapy is what that is. All right, hot diggity dog, Pete. How about number two?
This one says, this person says, I love hot dogs on the grill during the summer, but I'm guessing they're not healthy food. So what is a good option for summer grilling, Sherry?
Yeah, well, if you want to put it under the category of food, you're right. It is probably one of the worst options. But again, I am not about like restricting, like we had just talked about. I don't think having, you know, a hot dog every now and then is going to kill you. So I think it's okay to enjoy it. Now, I think better alternatives would be grilling like chicken breast, grilling grass-fed beef, you know, burgers. You could do kebabs. I mean, there's so many different options. Other than obviously just always eating the hot dogs. But, it's, you know, again, I think it's okay once in a while.
You ever see these people, the vegetarian people, they grill the carrot and have a carrot hot dog? That
sounds depressing.
I can't
honestly
bring myself to that yet.
Yeah. I would probably eat that because I love carrots.
It depends on how it's prepared, I guess. All right.
Yeah.
Sherry, question number three is intriguing because everybody wants it now. Go ahead, Mr.
This person says, I'm losing weight, but not as quickly as I want.
I want it faster.
Can I speed up the process? Throw the weight loss in the microwave or something. Can you do it?
Yeah, I mean, that's a question that obviously you can't answer when you don't really have any information. I mean, you know, what is the process? What I will say is obviously the majority of people take the approach of restriction, you know, they cut the calories, and we know that that is not effective long term. It is effective short term for about 2 to 3 weeks, and then the body responds. So you have to, you know, you have to know what you're doing. And again, not to sit here and say, oh, you need us, but nowadays it's almost like you do, because everyone has been doing it wrong for so long. So you have to be strategic to really move that process along. And it's not about, oh, maybe I just need to keep lowering calories, because that can be counterproductive. One last thing I do want to say about that, which is so important, is people look at the weight on the scale. That is the worst thing you can do. You have to get a body composition scale, because if you don't know what you're losing, none of it really matters.
Exactly. You can live and die on the scale, because if you don't know what you're losing, if you're on the scale, what you're really losing, Sherry, is your mind eventually, because you're on the scale constantly and you're going, why isn't this working? Hey, stop it. It will work with Wayless MD and Wellness, Southport Plaza in Kenosha. Sherry, how do I find out more about your programs, in-person, online, franchising, the whole shebang?
The whole shebang. They can go to our website, WeightLossMD, or give us a call at 262-226-2046.
All right. It's carrot dogs for everybody. Sherry Stoka, WeightLossMD and Wellness. You have a great week.
You too, guys. Thanks.